All right. Hey, YouTube, I'm Lucky, and this is the Trials Meta Report. This is a series I've been doing for a very long time now, where I basically break down the data from last weekend of Trials to give you the best information you can possibly use so that you can go flawless this next weekend and hopefully every weekend in Trials of Osiris. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get this started. The numbers are up on the screen here. Fellwinter's Lie, the most used weapon, no surprises there. As I've mentioned many times before, the strongest shotgun in the game. The Steady Hand fell to the number 2 slot. It was the most popular weapon last week, but that was because Iron Banner was out. Maybe it got a lot more popularity because people realized that these 120s are so very strong. I also think that the map this week was Pacifica, which was a little bit of a more close range map. You couldn't properly utilize the 120 range, and so I think a lot more people were looking to 140 RPM hand cannons or other solutions besides just the 120. So I think that's why Steady Hand is number 2 and not number 1 like it was last week. The Adored Sniper, the best sniper in the game currently because they sunset the Revoker and the Beloved. The Seventh Seraph, the best shotgun to use if you do not have the Fellwinter's Lie. The True Prophecy, the true best hand cannon in the game, in my opinion, in my humble opinion, is down in the number 5th slot. It would be much higher if it was in the loot pool, though. However, I think a lot more people would farm for this. The number 6 most used weapon is the Sturm, a very solid 120 RPM, especially if you get the Callus for this. It actually has really smooth handling, so it's actually pretty nice. But without the damage boosting perk, you can never 2-tap with it. So I really think that the edge goes to the other ones that you can 2-tap with, because it feels great to hit a 2-tap with a 120. If you've ever done it before, it's nice. The Arbalest is destroying people with on console and people with controllers. A very strong weapon. I always see people talking about this on console forums. Just they're so pissed off about the Arbalest. So Arbalest might get an adjustment soon here. Still very, very strong, very, very potent exotic. The number 8 slot goes to the Crimson, another console-specific weapon, I think. Very strong hand cannon, burst hand cannon. And then the last word, console as well. And then Dire Promise is the only 140 that makes it into the top 10. Now, there's not a whole lot of deviation from this week to last week. That's why I'm not focusing on this as much. But I do think that one thing will be interesting this week is that now that we have the Hawkmoon Catalyst and we have Hawkmoon Random Rolls, I don't see any reason why Hawkmoon will not be in the top 10. And so what I want you to do right now is comment down below what position you believe the Hawkmoon will be in when I make next week's trials report, and I'll see if you're right. I'll come back to the comment section, and if you're right, I'll give you a heart on the comment, and if you're wrong, well, then I'll ban you from the comment section. I'm kidding, of course, but so I'll see where you're at. My opinion, you don't have to agree with me. Comment down below your position first, rank 1 through 10, or if it's not even in the top 10. My opinion is that the Hawkmoon is probably going to slide into at least the 5th slot. At least the 5th slot. It's not even in the top 10 right now. We give it the Catalyst. You get Rangefinder on it. If you get a God Roll, Killing Wind, it's got to be in the top. It's got to be the 5th slot, in my opinion. There's no way it's number 1. It could be number 1 because it just came out. So that popularity thing, like the Steady Hand, it could be number 1. I would be really surprised, though. I'd be really surprised if it was number 1 or number 2. But it could be. We'll see. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And we'll see if you're right when I make next week's Trials Report. Now, moving on to the next piece of data, we need to talk about the player base. This is very important. It's very important that Trials have around 200,000 to 300,000 at minimum players if you want to have a healthy experience in Trials. Now, I'm speaking as someone who's a Sherpa, someone who helps people in Trials every single weekend on live stream, and the player base feels great when there's around 200,000 to 300,000 at the lowest point. When it's above that, it feels even better. It feels so amazing, so much fun playing Trials, but when it's below 200,000, it feels terrible. And if it's below 100,000, Trials can truly be declared a dead playlist. And this week, we had 108,000 players. I mean, we are nearing a point of death with Trials right now. It is bad. Stasis is killing Trials big time. We can all agree on that. And then on top of that, they bring back the Adept weapons. But this week, they actually brought back the armor piece. You didn't even get an Adept armor piece. You just got a regular armor piece from last season. Was the Lighthouse loot? And it was along with it was a new mod, but it was a projectile speed mod, so not the best one. But along with it was a new mod, which is nice. But damn, what a real slap in the face to go flawless, to do one of the most difficult activities in Destiny 2. In fact, the most difficult thing to do in Destiny 2, arguably, in my opinion, and you can disagree if you want, is to go flawless in Trials of Osiris. That's more difficult than any raid, I think. It's more difficult than any Grandmaster, and I do Grandmasters all the time. Going flawless is so much harder than every activity in the game. And when you go flawless and you open that chest and you get a piece of armor from last season and it's going to be sunset in 9 months from now, that's some bullshit, in my opinion. And that's why a lot of people aren't playing this playlist. The most challenging playlist does not give the most rewarding loot. And that's a big problem, Bungie. You need to fix that. You need to work on that. Let me know your thoughts on that in the comment section below as well. I'll be reading all of your comments. And that's a wrap for this Trials Report. I'm going to keep it nice and short and sweet because there's not a whole lot of deviation from this week's meta from last week's meta. But next week, we'll see. We'll see how the Hawkmoon does. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching. Later.